What has been the toughest thing about being female in a war zone or in uniform? Would you want to see women be allowed into combat? I advocate for it very strongly. I would like women, you know, it's happened in Israel, it's happened in the United States of America. We can't keep saying, what if a woman gets taken POW and have that be the singular reason that we don't allow women into combat roles? I mean, you were in a combat role without it being officially an infantry role. Would you support women in combat, Gunjan? And what personally for you has been the toughest thing about being a woman in uniform?
I think being the toughest part of being a woman in uniform, other than the minor things that, you know, the infrastructure part, you know, because that I think just slowly took care of, was taken care of. I think other than that was breaking that mental barrier which people had, you know, that making them accept you as a professional was, I think, the toughest part of being in uniform and being accepted as an officer and, you know, not being looked at as a woman officer is what I think was the toughest part. And I think the most challenging and exciting part as well. And
Would you support women in combat? Would you support
women? Yeah, coming to that part of your question, 100%, you know, there is no way. Because why are you there, you know, in uniform if you don't want to get into combat?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You are there. That's, you are being trained for that. You are wearing the uniform for that. So, I mean, there has to be no second thoughts about it anyway, you know. And let me tell you, Barkha, you know, not only me, I think I haven't come across any woman officer who thinks otherwise. And as far as, you know, your question, and this is a very valid question, I think, for the organization and for the country as well, you know, that what, you know, what if they're taken as POW and what will happen after
that? It's not my question. I'm saying this is what I'm told all
the time. Yeah, this is the general, you know, thing. Even when I was in service, because I was from the initial few batches, we were asked this question very often, you know, by different, you know, people. So I think I never gave that reply, and I never saw any woman officer till date. I've never met anybody who gives that reply that I don't want to get into combat because, you know, the fear of becoming a POW is there. Yeah. The fear of becoming a POW is there for everybody, not only for a woman, you know. It's not as if, you know, if a male officer or a warrior is, you know, taken as POW, they are treated well. They are certainly not treated well, and that we all know. So
When you sign up for your job, sign up for everything that comes with it.
I get commissioned the day I opt for this uniform. It is there and I accept it as, you know, a part of whatever my profession.
Janhavi, let me ask you a last question. What has been the learning, if any, like a kind of life learning from being exposed to somebody like Gunjan, who comes from a regular middle class background, who doesn't have the kind of privileges in a sense that you have always been cushioned by, which you've spoken about? And a lot of times, you know, people are harsh. They will judge you harshly, not just for being female. They'll also judge you harshly for being privileged, for being rich, for being, you know, the daughter of a film family. All of that is going on in a noisy way all around you. So then you meet somebody ordinary yet extraordinary in the middle of it, right? How does this experience change you, given all the noise about your privilege that's raging all around you at this moment?
I think it's extremely inspiring, and it made me feel extremely hopeful, because I know the noise is extremely loud right now, but it was present even then, and I think it's been something that I've considered my entire life, because I know I've been very aware of the privilege that I come from. I know that I have a sort of, for the lack of a better word, a fast track almost into opportunities from, because of the background that I come from. But I think what I learned from Gunjan ma'am and this experience especially, and also from my parents and I think my general upbringing, is that it comes down to your work. And more than that, it comes down to the effort that you put in and the hard work that you put in. And I know that because of the privilege that I come from, I've kind of skipped a process that most are subjected to. So even if I work as hard as everyone else, I still don't think that's enough for me. I think that there needs to be much more of an effort to make up for that, to prove that I'm deserving of an opportunity that I don't even think I'm deserving of. But
so you feel guilty about your privilege?
there have been many times that I've been made to feel apologetic. And yeah, there was a full phase where I was like, I definitely don't deserve it. But what am I going to get out of sitting and feeling guilty about it? I should use it to my advantage. And I should feel blessed. And I can't wait. I think it's a sin to have an opportunity the way that I do. Opportunities like I do. And to waste it and to not dedicate all of my being to making the best of it that I can. Not only for myself, but out of respect, I think, to everyone who feels robbed of opportunities and feels like they are more deserving of it. So I think I need to do it for them. And honestly, I feel like I don't think that people will and should accept me unless I'm extraordinary. Their standards are extremely high, but I think that it's a challenge and it'll motivate me to work that much harder to reach that level. And I just think that it'll be good for my art. So I'll take it as a challenge. And you're
playing an extraordinary woman. So I think that's
I am. And honestly, Barkha ma'am, her journey has inspired me so much. Like I know getting into this film was when I was going through this whole apologetic phase of like, you know, no one really thinks that I deserve to be here. But I can't use that as an excuse. She didn't use anything as an excuse. And so the stones that people throw at you, turn them into milestones, is something that I think Sachin Tendulkar said. So
well done.